Hey everybody, it is your girl here, Genuinely Divine, and today is wash day. So I'm going to be using the Shea Moisture Manuka Honey and Mafura Oil Collection. I will be using the conditioner, shampoo, and mask. I will also be doing a hot oil treatment in my hair using Jamaica Black Castor Oil, also Jojoba Oil, Sweet Almond Oil, and Do Grow Mega Thick Growth Oil. Now, I've never done a hot oil treatment before, so I'm just using oils that I think will be good. I'm going to start off using the moisturizing shampoo, intensive hydration shampoo in my hair. My hair is really dirty, you guys. This is like a week old hair. I did not wash my hair. None this week. I was trying to see how long it would last, and it really didn't do that well for me. I have to wash my hair at least every 3 days. Otherwise, my hair will flake on me. So, yeah. This picture on the side, you guys, this is when I first cut my hair in June. The picture on the left side, it was like really, really short, and it started growing. The picture on the side is actually October. Now I'm going to start off by taking out my bantu knots. I do wear bantu knots in my hair like almost every single week because my sides, I don't like my sides out. I actually want to get it cut, but I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do. But I do like the taper look, so the frohawk is what I wear all the time. I am using the shampoo right now. I'm using the little massager. You can't really see it, but it's in my hand, and I'm kind of like, you know, like massaging my scalp. I sped up the video just a little bit so it wouldn't be a lot of time wasted on you watching me wash my hair, but I did just want you guys to see the lather of the shampoo. It's a really great lather. Okay, you guys, I've rinsed the shampoo out of my hair, and now I've already added some conditioner to it. It is from the Manuka Honey line. I'm going to put a little bit more now so you guys can see. I'm going to focus on the center of my head because this is where my weak spot is, you guys. I don't know why, but my hair feels really, really dry in that location, and it's very difficult for my hair to coil in that area also. So I'm just massaging the conditioner all through my hair. I try to massage it into the scalp or whatever, all over my head basically. Now you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and add all of my oils into an applicator bottle so that I can get ready to distribute it all over my head. After you guys add all of your oils that you wish to use for your hot oil treatment, you need to have some like boiling hot water so that you can sit the applicator bottle into the water. And you may want to let it sit in there for like a minute to 3 minutes, whatever you choose to do. You don't want it to be too hot for your hair. And this water was extremely hot, you guys. And for some odd reason, I cannot get the applicator bottle to sit still. I probably needed something a little bit heavier. I'm not sure. Like I said, this is my first time ever doing a hot oil treatment, so I'm not sure how this is going to turn out, but I'm just gonna massage it into my scalp. I did wash this on one of the videos. It's a natural hair video. I'm not exactly sure who they were, but I watch a lot of their videos, so I will put their names up. I will put their names in the description box below so you can check out their channel. I'm just massaging the oil all through my scalp, trying to make sure that I'm focusing on my scalp, because hot oil treatments are definitely for your scalp, and your hair grows from your scalp, so you definitely want to have a healthy scalp. So guys, just for reference, I did not wash out the conditioner. I left the conditioner in and I added the oil to my scalp. Now I'm going to add the mask from the Manuka honey line also while the oil is still in my scalp. And I'm going to like actually put my plastic caps over my head. Once I'm done adding the mask all over my hair, I'm gonna put a plastic cap over it and then I'm gonna get under the dryer for maybe like 45 minutes. I usually use two caps, you guys. Now I'm gonna sit under the dryer and I'm going to work on some astrology content for Genuinely Divine. Okay, you guys, I am out of the dryer. I have rinsed my hair already. I'm gonna use the Shea Moisture for Damaged Hair conditioner as a leave-in conditioner. And I'm just gonna rub it all through my hair. I'm not gonna put a lot because I do not like a lot of products in my hair. My hair is low porosity. It does not absorb products very fast or easily. So I don't want a heavy buildup. This is why I wash my hair like almost every 3 days so that I don't get flakes and I don't have a buildup of products. Now I don't usually use oil in my hair, but I'm gonna try it because someone told me try it out, but I really don't like to put oil in my hair. I don't know why. It runs down in my face and it tends to break me out or something. I just really don't like it, okay? But I'm gonna try it out just a little bit. Now you guys, I'm gonna start doing my bantu knots on the side. Like I said, you guys, I wear my hair the same, like almost every day, every week, I wear my hair the same. Until it really grows out to something different, I'm probably gonna wear this style for quite some time. And I'm having a difficult time doing the bantu knots today, but I'm doing the best I can. Okay guys, the bantu knots are done on both sides. I have 4 on each side. Now I'm gonna get ready to start the finger coiling process. Now this is the part that everyone asked me about. They were like, how do you define your curls? Do you roll your hair? No, I do not roll my hair. I actually just take my finger and I coil my hair. But for those of you who think that coiling your hair with your finger takes a little bit too long, is just a little bit too time consuming, then you can just use your brush. You can put your Eco Styler gel in your hair, with, you know, spray, you know, you want to spray your hair with water, put your Eco Styler Geller on your hair, and you can just take the thin brush and brush it. As you can see, once you put your products in your hair will naturally curl. Your natural curl pattern will come through. You can leave it that way, or you can go in and define it. I just go in and define my curls because that's the look that I like on me, my face, and for my style. That's what I like. Now, again, as you can see, you put your products in your hair and you brush your hair, your hair will naturally curl. Your natural curl pattern will come through. You can leave it like this, just go through each section and brush it, put product on it and brush it through, and you can leave it that way. But I just really like to define my curls. So I'm gonna go through and finger curl. So I'm gonna speed this up a little bit, you guys.
Look at what I've done.
Okay, you guys, now I'm doing the edges. I'm not that good at doing the edges, and I'm using this oil. It's called, I'm not exactly sure what it's called, but I'm gonna put it on the screen when I get a chance to. I'm gonna spray it on my hair. I just picked it up in Walmart. It looks like it was good. It has Shea moisture. It has Shea butter, coconut oil, and some other things in it. Now I'm just gonna pick out my curls. It's still a little wet, you guys, so I'm just, for the sake of the video, I'm gonna go ahead and pick them out so you guys can kind of like see my whole little routine. How do I get my little look that I wear pretty much every single day? So yeah, and it really feels so good, you guys. The hot oil treatment definitely made a difference. My hair feels so soft. It feels so good. It feels so healthy. I really like it a lot. I hope you guys like it too. So, you know, don't forget to like and subscribe, you guys. See you next time. Bye.